Hi friends, hope you are fine. Today let us understand G protein coupled receptor. At the end of this discussion, you will be able to understand why GPCR is the most studied receptor, why this receptor is called G protein coupled receptor, what are G proteins, and finally, the steps in GPCR pathway within 5 to 10 minutes. GPCR is targeted by 30 to 50% of clinically used drugs as this receptor can respond to wide variety of extracellular signals such as smell, taste, light, hormones like estradiol, neurotransmitters such as dopamine, and many other chemical signals. This receptor also controls important functions such as heartbeat, blood pressure, etc. As it is a promising therapeutic target, this is the most extensively studied receptor. Now let us see the structure of GPCR. GPCR represents the largest family of cell surface receptors. As you see, this receptor is a single peptide with a cytosolic region and a ligand-binding extracellular region. It is made up of 7 transmembrane helices. Here you can see it is numbered 1 to 7. So these helices are joined by 3 extracellular loops and 3 intracellular loops. As this is made up of 7 hydrophobic transmembrane helices, this receptor is also called as 7TM receptor. TM means transmembrane. So this is the structure of GPCR receptor. Now let us see why this receptor is called as G protein coupled receptor. So this receptor is associated with a protein which is called as G protein. G protein is a trimeric protein with 3 subunits, alpha, beta, and gamma. Alpha and beta subunits have small lipid molecules that helps them to attach to the inner layer of the plasma membrane. This G protein is called so as it is bound to either GDP or GTP. If this alpha subunit is bound to GDP, it is in off state or inactive state. Upon ligand binding, as you see, there will be a conformational change that causes this alpha subunit exchange this GDP for GTP. Then this receptor gets active or GTP bound alpha subunit or GTP bound G protein is an active G protein or in on state. These subunits has many classes also. Now let us see the pathway, GPCR pathway. First step is ligand binding on the extracellular ligand binding region. GPCR undergoes a conformational change upon ligand binding. Second step is this GDP bound alpha subunit exchanges GDP for GTP. That means it becomes on state or it becomes active. Third step is this active G protein activates adenylyl cyclase that converts ATP to CAMP. As we already discussed, CAMP is a second messenger that can activate inactive protein kinase A. This protein kinase A, as you see, it has 2 catalytic subunits and 2 regulatory subunits. In the fourth step, elevated CAMP levels activates protein kinase A. In step 5, this pKa phosphorylates several enzymes and transcription factors downstream like CREP, CAMP response element binding protein that can directly bind to DNA and cause gene expression. So these genes mediates cell growth and differentiation. So this is GPCR CAMP mediated pathway that lead to cell growth and differentiation. Let me repeat once again. First, upon ligand binding, GPCR undergoes a conformational change. G protein, from its inactive state, it exchanges GDP for GTP and it becomes active. Active G protein then activates adenylyl cyclase, an enzyme that converts ATP to CAMP. CAMP is a second messenger that activates pKa, protein kinase A, into an active state. This pKa phosphorylates several enzymes and transcription factors downstream, ultimately causing gene expression that mediates cell growth and cell differentiation. Let me add one more point also. The subunits of this G protein alpha, beta and gamma has many subclasses like alpha S, alpha 11, alpha 12, 13, etc. that mediates different pathways. For example, this alpha S can activate CAMP that lead to change in cell metabolism, growth and motility. So here alpha 1 can control cell motility, then this alpha 11 can activate DAG, diacylglycerol, IP3 calcium ions, etc., lead to cell proliferation, and this alpha 12, 13 can mediate tumor progression, whereas beta and gamma subunits together can activate phospholipase C, causing desensitization or apoptosis. So this receptor can mediate n number of pathways, so having a prominent impact on cell growth, cell differentiation, cell motility, apoptosis, etc. That is why this is the most studied receptor and most promising therapeutic target. Hope you understand the pathway. Thank you so much. Take care. Stay blessed. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com.